Now, we've had some requests for a winter scene that's good and cold, so let's do one of those. Let's start out today. We'll use the old 2-inch brush here. We went to a small amount of the phthalo blue. Just a small amount. Pull it out and then just tap the bristles right into the color. That assures a nice even distribution of color all the way through the bristles. See there? Okay, let's go up here. Now then, maybe we'll have a little water. For that, I'm going to use the same old phthalo blue and the least little bit of the midnight black. So we have blue and black, or black and blue, whichever your preference. Okay, let's go up in here. Shake off the excess. And just beat the devil out of it. That's the most fun part of this whole technique. And for that, I'm going to use just titanium white, the old fan brush. And you could do this with a 1-inch brush or 2-inch brush. It didn't matter. Thought today we'd just do one with the old fan brush, though. Let's take a little bit of phthalo blue and alizarin crimson. And I want to make a lavender color, but I want it to the blue side. I'm going to keep everything in the blue tones in this painting to keep it cold. Blue is it's a cold color. Ooh, very cold color. It's hard to tell what that is. So we take a little white, lay it right there, and then mix some color into it to see if it's what we want. And that's pretty good. I sort of like that one. There, something like so. That's not bad. Okay, cut off our little roll of paint as usual. Let's go right up in here. And let's have some fun. We'll put some Prussian blue. It's much stronger. Prussian blue is much stronger. We'll put it right in that same color. So we get Prussian blue. I'll add a little more alizarin crimson to it. But this is a very dark lavender now. Very dark. Ooh. There. Cut off our little roll of paint once again. Lives right on the edge of the knife. Let's take, put that over there out of the way. Save it for later. I'm going to take some phthalo blue, and some white, and some black. Mix them together. There we are. I want a nice blue-gray color, but with the phthalo blue, so it's a little more bright than if you did it with the Prussian blue. Wipe off the old knife here. And let's take a fan brush, load it full of this color. Just work it back and forth in the paint. Both sides full of color. Now then, you wouldn't believe I have 2 squirrels that live in the house, and I have 3 that live outside. They're about ready to be turned loose now. But the ones that live in the house, if you've never lived with a squirrel, you haven't lived. Because they will get into absolutely everything. Every single thing in the house. And I find, because they hide nuts all over the house too when they run around, and I'll find nuts in everything from my pockets to my shoes. But it's fun. Let's take some Prussian blue, black, alizarin crimson. Shoot, we'll even throw some Van Dyke brown there too. Doesn't matter. Good dark color. Can't even clean off the old knife here. Tell you what, it's time for your bravery test. Let's take the old 2-inch brush and go right into that pile of paint. Now, today I want to bring this brush to a nice chisel edge. So to do that, bring it through the paint, wiggle it. That pulls the paint down to the end of the bristles, wiggle it. And then go through and sharpen it, just like you would a fine knife. Look how sharp that brush is. But you can bring it to a very sharp chisel edge. I have several old brushes going here. I'm going to take another 2-inch and put titanium white on it. A little bit of the phthalo blue. A little phthalo blue. So I have a blue color in the bristles. Okay. Let me see. Now I'm going to take one corner and go through white paint. All right. So I have blue deep in the brush and white on the tips. All right. Now then, I'm going to dip the brush into liquid white. Then we'll go right through titanium white. Pull the brush in one direction. See there? Load a lot of paint into it. A lot of paint. Biggest mistake made is not enough paint. When I lived in Alaska, it's unbelievable. Jack Frost would come through there and do his magic. And the trees would be covered with ice fog. It had frozen, and it's the most gorgeous thing you have ever seen. It's called cold in Alaska during the winter, but it may be as beautiful as the summer. Take a little titanium white, and maybe we can see a little snow right in there. Take a little dark sienna and paint thinner. And we want to make his paint thin, very thin, almost the consistency of ink. You probably can see it running there. It's that thin. Now, while you have that, you can pull one side of that right through the little liquid white. There we go. This is a very simple little painting. If you've never painted before, it's a good one to try, especially if you like very cold winter scenes. So I do hope you give it a try. From all of us, I'd like to wish you happy painting.